Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Miami Mike Show. And here's your host, Miami Mike.
Tonight's a special night, like always. Dolphins, Jets, the rivalry, the Jets being in Florham Park, me being a huge or probably the number one Dolphin fan in the country. This is a very special night here at Miami Mike. So I want to thank you all for being here and being ready for the rivalry tonight. But what a day yesterday, week six. Let's recap yesterday, week six. But before we get into yesterday, Dan Weldon yesterday, the Indy driver, got killed in an accident. And like Al Davis, we're going to just take a moment of silence because of the sports and the horrific accident it was. He was a two-time winner, and he lost his life yesterday at the age of 33 years old. So we'll take a moment of silence right now for Dan Weldon. Thank you. Now we're going to talk some football. How about the passion yesterday with Jim Schwartz and Jim Harbaugh yesterday? The 49ers and the Lions, what a game. The game was fantastic, and at the end, the coaches were going at it. I like to say that's passion. That's right. That's passion. And these two teams are actually becoming two of the better teams in the NFC. And yesterday, the game was awesome. The coaches battling. I loved every moment of it. So to the Jim Schwartz and Jim Harbaugh, the 49ers and the Lions, keep doing what you're doing, baby. You deserve it. Actually, in the Bay Area with the Oakland Raiders and the San Francisco 49ers, things are changing out there, and it's pretty amazing now. The Raiders are 4-2, but they did lose their quarterback, Jason Campbell, which is a huge loss yesterday for the Raiders. Rumor is Carson Palmer may be in negotiations with Cincinnati to get out of Cincinnati and into Oakland right now out west. I think that'll be a great, great setup. So anyway, how about the Giants yesterday? Giant football, big win. Beating Buffalo, taking care of the Bills, and helping the AFC teams out. But the Giants did it. Ahmad Bradshaw, 3 touchdowns yesterday. It was amazing. We love it, actually. Our guest a little later on is going to be Rodney Hampton. What a day it was also for the Buccaneers as they took down the New Orleans Saints in a big division matchup. The Saints and Drew Brees, one of the better teams in the NFC, made a comeback but fell just a little short. What a day it was yesterday in the NFL. Let's review our top passes, receivers, and rushers. Yesterday's top passer was Drew Brees of the New Orleans Saints. 383 yards and 1 touchdown. Top rusher, Rashad Mendenhall, 146 yards, 1 touchdown. And our top receiver, Akeem Baldwin of the Baltimore Ravens yesterday. Also, real fast, BCS standings right now after week one in the BCS. It's LSU, Alabama, and Oklahoma, the top three in the BCS. All right, ladies and gentlemen, he's here all the way from Houston, Texas. Went to the University of Georgia, won Super Bowl 25 with the New York Giants. He's a two-time Pro Bowler. Put your hands together for Rodney Hampton, everybody.
Hello, Mike. Welcome, what's going on? What's going on?
Rodney Hampton at Miami Mike's tonight. How are you, buddy?
Glad to be here, man.
Yeah, man. It's nice to see you. How's your golf game going?
Getting better.
Getting better.
Getting better. I'm beating two guys, you know, O.J. Anderson and Gene.
Well, that's what I meant. O.J. Anderson and Gene.
He called himself Hammer, so his name is Gene. I would not call him Hammer anymore.
Okay. But you're beating them two, and that's the most important,
yes,
right?
You're
taking them down.
Yes, sir.
Oh, baby. And so, Hamp, what have you been up to since your football career has ended? What's been going on?
Well, this in Houston, I'm married with two kids, three kids. I got a daughter 5 years old.
Uh-oh.
Tell my wife, baby, forgive me.
He has three kids, not two. That was my bad. He's a little hot and flustered up here.
I got a bail bonding company, A Better Bail Bond. We bail people out of jail and keep them out of jail, educate them how to stay out of jail and their rights and all that good stuff.
It's awesome.
I do Hamps Camp after school program.
How's that going?
It's going.
I participated in that a few years ago across the way when we
always
had the
ball. Always, Mike, thank you for all your support with Hamps Camp. It's based on my passion, you know, helping kids out. We do after school programs for kids. We got 3 schools in Houston, Texas right now. And it's pretty much getting out and exercising. And I'm teaching the fundamentals of football. And now we have 3 girls. That's in the class now. I added a second class called All Sports.
Excellent.
So it's enhanced camp, you know, just getting out and having fun. And I just got a passion for, you know, the kids. And just teaching them 3 things that I talk about. Believing in yourself, hard work, and being disciplined. And you do them 3 things, it'll take you a long ways in life.
Well, you know, I mean, you had a great career in the NFL. You played at the University of Georgia. Tell us about your college career coming out of high school. Was Georgia the school? Did you want to play at Georgia? Where did you get recruited from, and how did that process go for you?
Well, I got recruited by a lot of schools, all the schools in the country, but my main school, the school that I wanted to go to was SMU.
Well, they were strong back in the day.
Oh, they were
right?
Very, very strong.
Right.
I was a big Eric Dickerson fan.
And he played at SMU.
SMU, the Pony Express.
Yeah, that was phenomenal. That was a great team.
A great team. So I was a big Eric Dickerson fan, so that's all I, you know, wanted to go to SMU. So the year I was coming out of high school, they got hit by the death penalty.
Yeah, once they get hit, well, that killed their recruiter.
Well,
that killed it, right?
They got hit by the death penalty, and I'm calling the coach, saying, I'm still going to come here. The coach said, Rodney, you don't understand. It's no more football here. So from that point, I had to, you know, focus on other schools, and Georgia, Oklahoma, Colorado, and Texas A&M. But Georgia just happened to be a great fit for me, and yeah. The rest is history.
The Bulldogs, I mean, I remember watching you back in the day at Georgia. It was exciting. And, you know, Georgia today, the program is, you know, it leveled off a little bit, but the University of Georgia and the Bulldogs, always a stand-up school. We enjoy watching them here, part of that great conference. Let's talk about a little bit about your Giant days, okay? Coming out as a rookie, you were first round, okay? You were the 24th overall pick in the first round.
Right.
Okay, when you heard your name called by the Giants, what went through your mind? What were your emotions like?
Actually, I was excited, but people don't know, right before the Giants, the 49ers picked right after the Giants. So the 49ers called me on the phone. I talked to them on the phone. They said they were going to pick me. And I said, okay, I'll be ready. But then while I'm on the phone with them, I see my name and picture on the screen.
The Giants took it right before the 49ers.
The Giants picked me, so, you know, I was happy. You know, I came to the Giants, a great organization, and had a great career, and, you know, Giants had great fans also.
Yeah, well, I still want to talk about the Giants, but since we're talking about the Niners, what is your take on yesterday's Jim Schwartz and Jim Harbaugh, a little tussle after the game? What are your thoughts on that?
I think that's just a little passion in the game.
I love it, man. I was excited. Yeah. The fans were going nuts.
I still haven't saw the interviews what happened, you know, after the game. But, you know, I think they might get a slap on the wrist, a little fine. But, I mean, yeah. That's good for the game. I mean, coaches having
the
passion.
Rivalry, that's a rivalry now.
Exactly.
They don't like each other.
Exactly.
Coaches or players. It was awesome yesterday.
But I think those two guys, they coach together.
Yeah, they coach together. They coached in, I believe they coached back in Baltimore for a year.
Okay.
They coached, and then I heard they didn't get along too well back then either, so.
Well, it showed yesterday.
Oh, it did. And how about, what are you doing now for the Giants? Do you do some work for the Giants now? Do you do some events,
yeah.
Some appearances? What's going on now with the Giants yourself?
I'm an ambassador for the New York Giants. I still do a lot of personal appearance for the games, before the games and after the games, so. That's something I enjoy doing.
Okay. You were a two-time Pro Bowler your first 2 years with the Giants. The first year, you scored 14 touchdowns. Mm-hmm. The second year, you scored 5 touchdowns. Mm-hmm. And you still made the Pro Bowl both years. How was it going over there as a rookie and the second-year player in the NFL, making a Pro Bowl and playing with some of those athletes?
Actually, it was great just going to the Pro Bowl. It was great going over there, having a good time with the guys. Being voted by your peers, that's the most important thing.
Yeah, it was exciting, right?
Yeah, very exciting.
Especially a rookie right out of Georgia. The last thing you want, first of all, you want to get picked by a team.
Right.
Then you make the team, and then you go to the Pro Bowl all in 1 year. I would say that's a successful season for you.
Yeah, my first year, we won the Super Bowl. I got hurt. We got the Super Bowl ring right here to show.
Well, hey, Super Bowl 25 ring right here. Rodney Hampton, Super Bowl 25 ring. Wide right against Buffalo.
Yeah.
We'll talk about that in a second.
My first year won the Super Bowl. My second year, I had a pretty good year. Didn't go to the Pro Bowl. My third and fourth year, I was selected to the Pro Bowl. But it's great to be, like I say, picked by your peers and
right.
Be respected around the league and get over there. We just had a great time. And
was that in Hawaii? Was you playing in Hawaii?
Great, in Hawaii, yeah.
Nice place to visit.
Oh, yeah.
It was all expenses paid?
Yeah.
All right. Not bad. What about from 1991 to 1995, you gained 1,000 yards plus each season, okay? During that time, it was a little harder to get 1,000 yards. The season was a little shorter. How was your body after the season? Did you take a lot of, you know, running backs always get beat up. So, I mean, you gained 1,000 each of those years. You're getting a lot of carries. How was your body after the season?
Oh, I was extremely sore. I mean, I took a lot of pounding. You know, my first 2 years, we had a veteran quarterback, Phil Sims, so
yeah.
He can change cadence and change the plays. And After that, Dave Brown came in. He was a younger quarterback.
Yeah, they drafted him.
I saw a lot of 8-9 man front. So,
yeah,
you know,
big time.
3 yards in a cloud of dust. But, you know, just been an athlete and the player just going out and just doing my job. And I got 1,000 yards, but it's a tough 1,000 yards, you know,
yeah,
5 years in a row. But, you know, I won't change anything about it. I enjoyed it. I had a great career with the Giants and, you know, what a great city to play for.
Oh, you want New York. So it says. Your final season, 97, the rumors that you were going to get traded to San Francisco. To think they wanted to pick you in the beginning of your career and almost trade for you towards the end of your career. Would you have left and went to San Fran? I mean, you know, if you wanted to retire, what went on at the end with the retirement, maybe getting traded to San Fran? What went on with all that?
Well, Asher Adele said, I think 95, I had a pretty good season, and they had drafted Tyron Wheatley out of Michigan.
Right.
And, you know, he was, you know, slowed down by a couple injuries, and I went on to have a pretty good year. And then after the season, it was like, we're going to keep Rodney Hampton or what? And I became a free agent. And the New York Giants, you know, 49ers made me an offer, but New York Giants had 24 hours to match the offer, and they did.
Okay.
But to tell the truth, I'm glad I stayed in New York.
I
didn't really want, I can say it now, I didn't want to go nowhere, Mike.
No,
I didn't want to leave New York City.
I don't blame you. You know, you played under legendary coach in Parcells over there.
Right.
You were winning regularly, you know.
Right.
And, you know, it's a great thing playing in this metropolitan area, you know. Before we say goodbye, I brought something here for you, Ham.
Uh-oh.
Just something from back in the day I got.
Uh-oh.
Look at this, Ham. All right? There it is. Number 27, New York Giants. Rodney Hampton, his jersey right here. Ladies and gentlemen, our guest tonight with us from the New York Giants, Rodney Hampton, everybody. Our next segment is Ask Miami Mike. So let's welcome tonight our beautiful model, Lisa Marie Attino.
Definitely not a model.
All right. Come on, Lisa.
All
sit
right,
down.
Cool.
How's your week going this week, all right?
Good, good. My Giants had a great win yesterday,
yes.
So I'm happy.
Then,
very happy.
I'm happy for you, too. We love the Giants here at Miami Mikes. And if the Dolphins don't do well, we kind of root for the Jets. It's always good to have that playoff business, you know?
Definitely.
Well, we're going to ask Miami Mike right now, so we're going to answer a few of your questions, and then we're going to get ready for a huge rivalry game tonight. Where are we coming from here? Our first question of the night. From John, all the way from Union, New Jersey. What are you going to do if the Dolphins lose tonight? Get drunk.
You don't drink, though.
That's okay. Tonight, if I go to 0-5 and lose to the Jets and have to wake up tomorrow on my beautiful day off, I might need to get drunk tonight.
Oh,
so we'll
boy.
Play it by ear. One shot, one beer, I'll be feeling good. All right. That's all I could say. All right. Philly Phil, all the way from Philadelphia. Did yesterday's win over the Redskins save our season? Well, the NFC East is wide open. Even if you're 2-4 right now, like the Philadelphia Eagles are, your season was saved yesterday by that big win. Philly is still in the hunt for the division as well as wild card, and when push comes to shove, they will be back in it. The Eagles are still alive and kicking. All right, Jeff from Pine Brook, New Jersey. What do you think about Ahmad Bradshaw's 3-touchdown performance yesterday? I think that the Giants really needed to establish the run. They can't rely on Eli Manning. And yesterday, Ahmad Bradshaw's touchdowns got the job done for the Big Blue as they're victorious and in sole possession of first place this week in the NFC East. Scott. How do you run a successful Miami Dolphins bar in New Jersey? Well, it's like what I like to call passion for the love of the game. It's called Miami Mike's. And if you ever walk through here on a Sunday football, you'll realize that we have about 10 fan clubs from all the NFL teams scattered throughout Miami Mike's. So yes, we are Miami Mike's Sports Zone for my love of my Dolphins, but we are the number one sports bar because we take care of all of our teams and all of our NFL fans. Game on.
Game on.
Dick Fisher from Hoboken, New Jersey, my hometown. Dick, where are you, Dick Fisher? Where are you, in the back there? Welcome all the way from Hoboken. Why are the Jets so much better than the Dolphins? Well, first of all, I think that it has to do with some coaching right now. I don't think the Dolphins coaching staff is one of the better staffs. The Dolphins coaching staff is right now living week to week, and in the NFL, that's no way to coach. I think Rex Ryan is doing a good job. He likes to talk a lot, but you know what? In the NFL, it's 16 weeks. Get the job done, and then you're on vacation.
All right, we have one more.
This is our final question before we get ready for Monday Night Football. I want to once again thank you all for watching the Miami Mike Show, being here at the Miami Mike Show. You can watch us tomorrow on YouTube. Nancy from Lincoln Park. What are the plans for the Giants in Super Bowl 2014? Well, I'll tell you what. It started with MetLife buying the naming rights for Super Bowl 2014 here at New Jersey. I honestly hope it snows all weekend, it's cold, and everybody stays in the hotel at the Ramada and comes down to Miami Mike's for the Super Bowl 2014. But it's going to be exciting having the Super Bowl here. I mean, if it's a Dolphin team there, will I be there? Who knows at the time. But Super Bowl 2014 is going to be here before you know it. MetLife Stadium is ready. And good luck to the Jets and the Dolphins tonight and all their fans. Just so you all know, tonight, my prediction is the Miami Dolphins tonight for tonight's Monday Night Football. Game on. Good night, everybody. Thank you.
When I step on the scene, y'all know me. Cause I walk with a limp like an old school pimp or real OG. I'm rocking bands. I'm in the sand. I got a Red Bull and vodka up in my hand. Hey, you looking kinda cute. Hey. In that polka dot bikini, girl. Hey, this what I wanna do. What? Take off that polka dot bikini, girl. Drink all day, play all night. Let's get it poppin'. I'm in Miami.